Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, we are going to cover the current affairs of 19th March. First question is, who has been named as India's first anti-corruption ombudsman? Right answer is Mr. P.C. Ghosh. So, former Supreme Court judge and current member of National Human Rights Commission, Mr. Pinaki Chandra Ghosh has been named as India's first Lokpal. If we talk about NHRC, that means National Human Rights Commission, it is a statutory body. It was formed in 1993 and presently Mr. H.L. Dattu is the chairman of NHRC. NHRC was also in news as recently it has launched a toll-free helpline 14433 to file complaints. NHRC was also in news as recently Mr. Prabhat Singh has been appointed as new Director General in NHRC. Now, if we talk about Lokpal, the Lokpal and Lokayukt Act 2013 contains the provision for Lokpal. If we talk about members, out of maximum 8 members, half of the members will be judicial members and minimum 50% of the members will be from SC, ST, OBC, minorities and women. The appointment of the chairperson and members is done by a selection committee. If we talk about selection committee, Prime Minister is the chairperson of selection committee. The selection committee constitutes Speaker of Lok Sabha and Leader of Opposition in Lok Sabha. Apart from that, the selection committee also constitute Chief Justice of India or the nominee of Chief Justice and one eminent jurist. Next is, which former ISRO scientist is the recipient of 2019 Padam Bhushan? Right answer is Mr. Nambi Narayanan. So former ISRO scientist Mr. Nambi Narayanan has been conferred the 2019 Padam Bhushan by President Mr. Ramnath Kovind. If we talk about few other awards, recently Gandhi Peace Prize awards were announced. For 2018, Mr. Yohi Shashakawa was given Gandhi Peace Prize. He was given this prize for his efforts towards eradication of leprosy. For 2017, it was given to Ekal Abhiyan Trust and for 2016, it was jointly given to Akshay Patra Foundation and Sulabh International. And for 2015, it was given to Vivekanand Kendra. On the other hand, recently, President Mr. Ramnath Kovind also awarded Bharat Ratan to former President Mr. Pranab Mukherjee and to Mr. Bhupen Hazarika and Mr. Nanaji Deshmukh. It should be kept in mind that Mr. Bhupen Hazarika and Mr. Nanaji Deshmukh were given Bharat Ratan posthumously. Recently, Tagore Award for Cultural Harmony were also announced. For 2016, it was given to Mr. Ram Vanji Sutar. For 2015, it was given to Chayanut, which is a cultural organization of Bangladesh. For 2014, it was given to Mr. Rajkumar Singhjit Singh, who is a doyen of Manipuri dance. Next is Soyuz spacecraft, sometimes seen in news, is associated with which country? Right answer is Russia. So, Soyuz spacecraft is a Russian spacecraft. If we talk about Russia, geographically, it is world's largest country. Russia was also in news as recently it unveiled world's first floating nuclear power station. Russia was also in news as recently Prime Minister Mr. Modi inaugurated Indo-Russian joint venture for the manufacturing of Kalashnikov rifles in Korva in Uttar Pradesh. Apart from that, the first ever India-Russia strategic economic dialogue held in St. Petersburg, the Indian delegation was led by Niti Aayog Vice Chairperson Mr. Rajiv Kumar. In addition to that, recently Russia-India-China Foreign Ministers meeting held in Wuzhen in China. Russia was also in news as recently a report was released by Stockholm International Peace Research Institute. The name of report is Trends in International Arms Transfer. As per this report, Russia is India's biggest arms supplier. Israel is on second position, while USA is on third position. If we talk about arms import, Saudi Arabia is world's largest arms importer from 2014 to 2018. India is second largest importer, while Egypt is third largest, and Australia is fourth largest. Next is, which of the following international organizations has recently adopted resolutions on single-use plastic and sustainable nitrogen management? Right answer is UNEA. So recently, the fourth session of United Nations Environment Assembly held in Nairobi in Kenya. and UNEA adopted two resolutions piloted by India on single-use plastic and sustainable nitrogen management. Now, the headquarters of UNEP is also in Nairobi in Kenya. UNEP stands for United Nations Environment Programme. It was formed on 5th of June 1972. And that's why 5th of June is Environment Day. If we talk about Nairobi, Nairobi is the capital of Kenya. Kenya is an African country. Recently, two more African countries were in news. Recently, Nigeria was in news. The capital of Nigeria is Abuja. Nigeria was in news as recently Nigerian President Mr. Muhammadu Buhari got re-elected. Apart from that, recently elections held in Senegal. The capital of Senegal is Dakar. And recently, Mr. Macky Sall has been re-elected as the President of Senegal. Senegal will be the host of 2022 Summer Youth Olympic Games. The 2018 Summer Youth Olympic Games held in Argentina in Buenos Aires. Next is, the registration of political parties is governed by the provisions of which sections of Representation of Peoples Act of 1951? Right answer is Section 29A. So the registration of political parties is governed by the provisions of Section 29A of Representation of Peoples Act of 1951. The political parties are registered by Election Commission of India. If we talk about Election Commission of India, it is a constitutional body. Article 324 contains the provision for Election Commission of India. Election Commission of India was formed on 25th of January 1950, and that is why 25th January is celebrated as National Voters Day. Presently, Mr. Sunil Arora is the Chief Election Commissioner of India. And recently, Mr. Sushil Chandra, who was the former CBDT chairman, has been appointed as the Election Commissioner. So, Mr. Sunil Arora is the Chief Election Commissioner, while Mr. Sunil Chandra and Mr. Ashok Lavasa are the Election Commissioners. Mr. Sushil Chandra was former CBDT chairman. Recently, Mr. Pramod Chandra Modi has been appointed as new CBDT chairman. If we talk about elections, recently Twitter also launched hashtag #PowerOf18 campaign to encourage people to contribute in public debates for the 2019 general elections. Next is Chinmay Roy, who passed away recently, was the waiter and actor of which regional cinema? Right answer is Bengali. Mr. Roy was a waiter and Bengali actor, and he passed away recently. If we talk about few other personalities who passed away recently, Mate Mahadevi passed away. She was the prominent Lingayat leader. Recently, Ms. Vinod Kashyap also passed away. She was associated with All India Radio. Apart from her, Mr. Daryl DeMonte also passed away. He was a senior journalist as well as environmental activist. On the other hand, Professor Walt Smith also passed away. Professor Smith popularized the term global warming. And Mr. Jerry Merriman also passed away. He was the co-inventor of pocket calculator. Next is, which of the following banks have been designated as RBI's list of domestically systematic important banks? Right answer is SBI, ICICI and HDFC. Recently, RBI has named three banks as DSIB. Now, first understand what is DSIB. DSIB are those banks which are so much important for the financial system. If something wrong happens with these banks, entire financial system will face the problem. So, as per RBI, SBI, ICICI Bank and HDFC are domestic systematically important banks. RBI comes with the list every year since 2015. If we talk about SBI, it was in news recently as it has launched doorstep banking service for senior citizens over 70 years of age and for differentially abled customers. Recently, RBI and Bank of Japan have signed a bilateral swap agreement for $75 billion. RBI was in news as RBI has also launched SRPHI. It is a survey on retail payment habits of individuals. RBI was also in news as recently RBI constituted a task force to look into the issues related to offshore rupee markets, and Ms. Usha Thorat is the head of this task force. If we talk about banking, recently the BCG IBA report was released. The name of report is Ease Reforms for Public Sector Banks. As per this report, PNB, that means Punjab National Bank has been ranked first in the EASE. EASE stands for Enhanced Assess and Service Excellence. Next is, where is the headquarters of CPCB? CPCB means Central Pollution Control Board. Right answer is New Delhi. The headquarters of CPCB is in New Delhi, and recently NGT, that means National Green Tribunal, has directed the CPCB to prepare a noise pollution map and remedial action plan to solve the issue across the country. If we talk about CPCB, it is a statutory body. It was formed in 1974 and it is under Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Presently, Mr. S.P. Singh Parihar is the chairperson of CPCB. If we talk about NGT, it is National Green Tribunal. NGT is also a statutory body. It is created as per the provisions of National Green Tribunals Act. Presently, Mr. Adarsh Kumar Goyal is the chairperson of NGT. The principal bench of NGT is in New Delhi, while other benches are in Bhopal, Pune, Kolkata and Chennai. Next is, which of the following states had started census of otters? Right answer is Uttar Pradesh. So recently, for the first time, Uttar Pradesh has undertaken a census of otters in its protected areas. The exercise will begin in Pilbhit Tiger Reserve. If we talk about Uttar Pradesh, it was in news recently as the 15th Pravasi Bhartiya Divas event held in Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. The theme of event was Role of Indian Diaspora in Building a New India. And the Prime Minister of Mauritius, Mr. Pravind Jugnauth, was the chief guest of event. UP was also in news as recently Prime Minister Mr. Modi has flagged off Vande Bharat Express, and the route of Vande Bharat Express is from New Delhi to Varanasi. Vande Bharat Express is India's first engine-less semi-high-speed train. Apart from that, Uttar Pradesh was also in news as recently Prime Minister Mr. Modi has launched Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi Yojana from Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh. There was one more scheme which was announced during interim budget. It was Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan scheme, and recently it was launched in Vastral in Gujarat. Gujarat was also in news as recently Prime Minister Mr. Modi launched National Common Mobility Card in Ahmedabad in Gujarat. Next is, which Indian psychologist is the recipient of 2019 Hans Killian Award? Right answer is Mr. Ashish Nandi. So Indian psychologist Mr. Ashish Nandi has been selected for the prestigious 2019 Hans Killian Award. Thank you, and that's all for the day.